I would complain about the improbable just-in-time rescue. If it wasn't just plain awesome. Here we are riding a saber-toothed bunny to attack an evil genie in a floating castle, with nothing but a farm boy, a furry, a lost boy, a genie, a sand warrior, and a moon bunny. Sometimes I wonder how I get in these situations. Hey, look! It's the human potion guy! And the fairy king? I knew it! The NPCs are plotting against me. Actually, it's just exposition. Turns out he knows the fairy king, and he is a good guy. The guy tried to help Toan through his journey by leaving treasures for him. Wait. Are you saying that he placed every single treasure chest that I found? It's always been funny in RPGs to think about all that free stuff just lying around in unlocked boxes. But I never thought that all the stuff was left there by one guy. I would say thanks, but he probably put those mimics here too. Oh, and the Fairy King's name is Simba. Moving on. Hey, Sephiroth. You notice all the treasure chests lying around? It's like some guys just leave them there to get stolen. What an idiot.
I knew you would make it. My name is Sita. This was my castle. It is also the place where the Dark Genie was created 400 years ago. My creation. 400 years ago, I was the king of the Eastern Terra, fighting the West to defend my people. Their armies were innumerable, and their magic devastating. It became clear that defeat was inevitable. On the eve of a pivotal battle, I was approached by a dark man. He said that he could give me power to defeat their armies. If the blood of a witch is mixed with the blood of a human, a tremendous dark power is created. He was probably using me as an experiment, but seeing no alternative for victory, I agreed. My magical power grew to 100-fold. It was a terrifying force. I used that power to destroy the armies of the West, but I had a price to pay. The dark blood now ran through my veins. Not long after that, there was a tragic incident. And my heart became full of anger and grief. And from that, something was born inside me. It grew great and frightening. Its power was absolute. Its blind fury burnt through every country in the East. This is how the genie was born. I searched feverishly for a way to erase my error. It was then that I learned of a stone called the Atlamelia, and that it would be created in 400 years. I used a forbidden spell to travel to this time, believing that the Atlamelia could seal the power of the Dark Genie. The Moon People were able to seal the young genie, but in the urn it grew in power. And now I fear that not even the Atlamelia can stop it. Toan. The Dark Genie is an embodiment of pure evil. It cannot die. The only way it can be destroyed is to stop it from being created. To change history. For that you must- I have no time. The dark blood in my veins is starting to take over. If he controls my mind, I will no longer be.
Sita. It's no use. Give yourself over to me fully. Your body, mind, and power.
No, I will not give up my body to you.
Now, I take first steps on my long journey. the forbidden spell. Walk Toen into the gallery of time. Erase his existence. Follow the fragments of my memory I left behind. They will show you what needs to be done. Now, go!
So this is the Gallery of Time. Interesting that the subspace between time and space looks like a dungeon. But whatever. I'm just happy there's no town to build. This time, I have to rebuild Sita's memories. You son of a- Oh look! The dancers from the beginning are enemies in this dungeon. Cute. Wait. Back in the beginning, they said they mixed witch and human blood in all the dancers was an essential part of the seal-breaking ritual. And the dark genie was created from witch and human blood. So we have a few dozen potential dark genies out there. Oh boy. Alright, we're here. Now we have to stop the event that caused so much grief as to create a monster of such pure evil. Wait, which one is real?
I see spy!
You failed to stop my creation. And no matter how many times you try, your efforts will always be futile. I am the incarnation of hate and misery. I am eternal. Now you will face your end here.
at the end of time.
Oh yeah? Right before this battle, I upgraded Osmond's weapon. So now I'm gonna kick your ass! The ranged weapon just turned into a flamethrower. And I can only hurt this guy with ranged weapons. Oh crap. Wait, he's attacking with purple hands with eyes? I know how to beat him.
You think that mere love can defeat me? By the power of love! Although I've been defeated, I will be reborn. For as long as I can feed off of his misery.
The Fairy King comes back for one last deus ex machina. He says that the Atlamalia can be sacrificed to bring back one person from death. And as I prepare to give up the gem that has been with us for so long, I can't help but think of everything we've accomplished, everything we've been through. Well, that's Dark Cloud. I hope you've enjoyed the series. Sorry if it was too long, but I had a lot of fun making it. Now that we've finished the game, there's a new dungeon? With over 100 levels? I didn't see anything, did you?